हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू वीडियो ऑन पीओपी एंड ओओपी। पीओपी स्टैंड्स फॉर प्रोसीजर ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग, वाइल ओओपी स्टैंड्स फॉर ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। लेट अस स्टडी फर्स्ट प्रोसीजर ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। व्हाट इज प्रोसीजर ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग? The problem is viewed as a sequence of small tasks to be done, such as reading, calculating, and printing. So, there will be the small tasks, and these small tasks are performing the separate operations, such as reading operation means input operation, calculating operation means processing operations, printing operation means output operations, and so on. And these operations are arranged in a sequence to solve a problem. Now, these tasks, individual tasks, are performed or accomplished in the form of function. There will be one function defined per task, and like this, all these tasks are accomplished by defining n number of functions for n number of tasks, and they are arranged in a particular sequence. Hence, the primary focus is on functions. The main entity in the POP is function. These functions are also called as procedures. So, procedure and function are the synonymous terms, and hence it is called as procedure-oriented programming, function-oriented or procedure-oriented. Program is viewed as a sequence of instructions for the computer to follow. So this small tasks are nothing but the set of instructions to be followed by the computer. Large programs are broken into number of functions. So whenever you are going to write a program to solve a particular problem, so that problem or that program is broken up or divided into number of functions. Let us understand with the help of figure. This is the figure of program structure of procedure oriented programming. In a program which follows the POP approach is having a main program. The main program is divided into number of functions. So here you can see the set of 7 functions are there, and all these functions are arranged in a particular sequence, and finally the main task will be performed. Like this, the main program is divided into small functions. So for example, here function 1, function 2, function 3. Function 1 is having the sub function 4, which is again having sub function 6, and so on. Like this, it is for function 2 and 3 also. So in this way, the program is divided into number of functions. Then these functions use two types of data. One is global data and second is local data. The global data is commonly accessed by all functions. So in a program there is some data in the form of some variables or array or pointers, and which are not the part of function, which are outside the function. They are declared in the program but outside the function, and like this is a global data. Global means what? It is available or accessed to all the functions within the program. So they are commonly accessible to all functions. Apart from that, each function may have its own local data. Generally, we are declaring the variables within the function, which are known as local variables, and these local variables represent local data. And the variables declared outside the functions represent global data. Global data is more vulnerable to frequent changes by multiple functions. As the global data is commonly accessed by functions, the multiple functions operate on it, and every function is performing certain operation on that global data, and hence the values are continuously changing. So that is frequent changes are there, that is vulnerability characteristic of global data. The functions are action oriented. They are performing certain action to solve the task. and they do not correspond to elements of the problem. There are some elements or the entities of the problem, such as student is the element, or book may be the element of problem, or any item may be the element of problem, employee may be the element of problem. So like this, these are the elements of problem. These are not represented or defined in terms of functions, because functions are performing only operations or the actions. Thus, POP does not model real world problems. So generally, our problems are real world problem. We are going to develop the software to solve the real problems, and in this software, the reality, in reality, there are certain physical entities, just like student, book, or account, bank account, etc. All these are the real entities, real time entities, and these are not modeled using POP approach. Now, this is a diagram of relationship of data and functions. There are three functions. For example, function 1 is having its own local data, function 2 is having its own local data, function 3 is having its own local data, and there is global data also in a program. This global data is commonly accessible to all these three functions. So like this, every function operate on its own local data plus global data. So this is the scenario of procedure oriented programming. Let us see the characteristics of POP. First characteristic is emphasis is on doing the things, that is the action or functions or procedures. So these are the synonymous terms. Large programs are divided into smaller tasks known as functions. So they are broken up, program is broken up into small functions or the small tasks, each task performed by a separate function. Most of the functions share global data. So there is a concept of global data, and which is accessible to all the functions within the program. Due to this, data move openly around the system from one function to another function. So one function can transfer the data to another function easily through global data, and thus the functions transform data from one format to another format, that is one form to another form. So one function may transform or convert the global data into another value or another format, and that new format will be available to another function, and so on. So like this, the data is changing from one form to another form. There is a top-down approach followed by POP. So this is the top-down approach in program design. Top-down approach means what? First of all, the program design it at higher level, and then it is broken up into small tasks in terms of functions. For example, the program starts with the main program, and in main program there are number of functions. So like this, this is the top-down approach. Now let us understand the second concept, that is object-oriented programming. Now we have seen there are certain drawbacks in previous paradigm, that is POP, procedure-oriented programming, and the new programming approach is OP. Obviously, whenever the new approach is coming, it is always focusing on removing the drawbacks of previous approach. So our previous approach is POP, and the major motivation of OP is to remove the drawbacks of this POP approach. OP treats both data and functions. So both are important as a single unit, as called as object. So data and functions in object. A problem is divided into number of objects. So there are number of entities known as objects. In OP, the data is critical element in a program. The main focus is on data rather than functions. In OP, the data is most important element in a program. The functions operate on this data of the object. So inside the object, there is data as well as functions, and these functions operate only on data of that specific object only. The functions cannot operate on the data of another object. The data is closely bound with functions, that is encapsulated. So they are tied together and data is thus protected from external world. Encapsulated means there is a capsulation. The capsule is the thing which is representing as a protection or the cover to the delicate thing, and that delicate thing is nothing but the data here, which is being protected from the external functions, means the functions outside the object. Now let us see the program structure of OOP. Here there are three objects: object A, object B, object C. Object A is having its own data and functions. Object B is having its own data and functions. Object C is having its own data and functions. Okay, so data of one object is accessible to functions of that object only. So now this data of object A is accessible to the functions of object A only. This data of object A is not accessible to the functions of B and C objects. The functions of one object can communicate with functions of another object. So there is a communication between two objects through functions. So there is a communication. This is a blue arrow, bidirectional line. Bidirectional arrow indicates the communication between object A and object B. This is the communication between object A and C. This is communication between object B and C. This communication is established through functions of individual objects. Let us see the characteristics of OOP. The main emphasis is on data rather than functions, as the data is the main entity of OOP. So the emphasis is obviously on the data, not on the function. The program is divided into number of objects. Functions and data are tied together in a data structure. So there is one data structure known as, we will further see, that is called as a class, in which the data and functions are bound together or tied together. And due to this, the data is hidden and is not accessible to the external functions. External function means the function outside the object. The objects may communicate with each other through functions. So it is possible to communicate the one object to another object, and through functions it is possible. New data or functions can be easily added to the objects whenever required. So as data and functions are restricted to one object only, if you are going to add new data or new function, the changes will be done within the object only. Other objects will not be affected. So like this, it is easy to do this type of addition. The OOP implements or follows bottom-up approach of program design. Bottom-up approach means what? First of all, the functions are implemented. The functions are forming the small modules to perform the task, and these small modules are integrated together to form a big or the higher level system. So that is the bottom-up approach. Now let us see the difference between OOP and POOP. POOP first. Emphasis is on doing things, that is a procedure or functions. While in OOP, emphasis is on data rather than procedure or functions. The second difference is, in POOP, large programs are divided into functions, while in OOP, the programs are divided into objects. The difference number three, most of the functions share global data. Now in OOP, there is no concept of global data. The function operate only on the data, which is the part of the object with which it is tied together. The next difference is, data can move openly around the system from one function to another function. So this is possible due to global data. The data is hidden and cannot be accessed by external function. So like this, data cannot move around the system in OOP. Next difference is, new data cannot be easily added to the functions. So as the functions are independent and they are combinedly as a part of main program, if there is a change in any one function, it will affect other functions, because every function may call another function. They are depending on each other, and one function may be the sub function of another function. While in OOP, just we have seen, the new data can be easily added to the function because It is a part of one object only. It is not affecting other objects. Next difference is the POP follows top-down approach of program design. The first main program, and within the main program there will be small functions to accomplish the small task. So the program design starts from higher level to lower level. In OP, that OP follows bottom-up approach. In bottom-up approach, the design starts from lower level and ends at higher level. The small modules are developed first, then they are integrated together to form a complete system. There are various procedure-oriented programming languages such as Fortran, COBOL, Pascal, and C. While C++, Java, C#, Python, these are the object-oriented programming languages. So, hope you understood the concept of procedure-oriented programming and object-oriented programming and the difference between them. Thank you for watching my video on POP and OP. Please do not forget to subscribe my channel Learn with HMG. And also, if you understood this video, so please click on like button. Thank you.